If future computers are to use piezoelectricity and work based on the strain effect, we must be able to study strain in a more systematic way. One of the methods I designed aims to fine-tune strain in highly crystalline films. Currently, we can create crystalline films with any desired strain state. We achieve this by using lattice mismatch to grow strained films on different substrates. By selecting different substrate cuts, we can control the strain state. Additionally, by adjusting the film thickness, we regulate the relaxation process. The main challenge is that once a film is made, its strain cannot be altered. This makes it difficult to study and isolate the strain effect from other contributing factors. The method I designed is simple and applicable to any type of film. It can adjust strain and reverse it as many times as needed. In this method, we attach the sample to a piezoelectric substrate using epoxy. By applying a voltage to the piezoelectric element, strain is generated and transferred to the sample. In this research, I collaborated with Auckland University. Dr. Sirinivasan had some experience in similar research using epoxies for bonding, and his research group measured several samples for me, which was very useful. I presented my research results at the APS meeting in Baltimore, Maryland in 2016. Here is a summary of the experiments. The method allows us to use the highest quality films without compromising anything to accommodate strain application. The measurements are extremely accurate, enabling us to easily measure the effect of strains as small as 1 part per million. There is a niche business opportunity for this technique. One could build a company to develop instrumentation for these types of experiments. Many universities and research centers will need such products. This is especially suitable for companies in the research lab industry, allowing them to create a division dedicated to strain studies using this method. My papers on this technique were delayed due to the ownership disputes with the University of Alabama. Eventually, I secured full ownership, but the university stole the data. You can see in the previous videos what they did. However, they cannot openly use it since I hold 100% legal ownership. So the best solution is that I release these techniques publicly for free. Money is not everything. The progress of knowledge is valuable in itself. So, this is up for grabs. You can repeat the experiments, master the technique, even add your own ideas to improve it, and then publish it in peer-reviewed journals. If you encounter any technical or scientific problems, please feel free to contact me. If you are an academic, I consult for free. And if you are from industry, we can work out a deal. This is a simple yet powerful technique for both academic and industrial research. Thank you for watching.